All right, back in the shop, back on stuff for this round. And of course, back on, if I can get my finger right, there we go. The Brute, it's over there somewhere, there we go. So back on the Brute, what are we doing, Aaron? What is the objective?
Okay, the goal?
I don't know, for today.
The goal is to, so these are all just tacked up. This one was tacked, but it got bumped really hard. So get all these all mocked up, go ahead and do the shock tabs on here and cut the holes for the ball joints and hopefully have some portal brackets hanging off of these arms with the shocks connected.
Sick.
Sick.
So I guess we'll just dive right in and get to work, start hanging some shocks and portal brackets, like you said, and just get to it like ain't nothing to it. So, sorry, I know I just like went all dark. We'll pick back up once we have something hanging. So, see you in a bit. So you just saw the old Gerb in a little time lapse situation.
This is what we've got so far.
Airplanes.
Yeah. Airplane God dang out. Airplanes out here.
We're filming here.
No respect. Anyway, we got that. That's his little angle finder, just so you guys know. It's not just some random orange block.
Yeah. That, neatest tool ever.
Yeah, Aaron's kids came and they brought us some toys.
Yeah, we like to like set blocks on stuff.
But here's the actual shock. I guess this would technically be a strut because it's the spring built on it, yeah?
I mean, yeah, technically, but...
Technically, but not technically?
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, shock. Here's the... It does say shocks right there. Racing shocks for all the racing this is going to do. Anyway.
They're coilovers.
Here is this... It's just tacked in, as you see. Everything we're doing right now is just tacked. Reason being is there's a lot of trial and error. Aaron has never built a custom... Well, full custom suspension, I should rephrase that, because, I mean, there's that, which is all the custom, but from scratch, none of us have. So,
there's that. We're waiting on, I guess, a cigarette break, so we can do the other side. And then we need the hole saw to do these.
Is this it?
Yep, that's the hole saw.
Okay, so we have the hole saw bit, but
because we're very unorganized, we have lost Alan's ball joints.
We don't know where the ball joints are.
They're somewhere. I bought them because I had to replace them because I stole his for the Rhino. So they're somewhere here. We're going to find them. So once we get to that point, that's probably where I'm going to pick back up at. But right now, we're going to get in some more time lapse. So we'll just see you right now.
I try to be everything that I can. But sometimes I come out as being nothing. I try to be everything that I can. But sometimes I come out as being nothing. I pray to God that He make me a better man. Maybe one day I'ma stand for something. I'm thanking God that He made you part of the plan. I guess I ain't go through all that hell for nothing. I'm always fucking up and wrecking shit. It seems like I perfected it. I offer you my love, I hope you take it like some medicine.
What are you doing here? What do you got? Like, why do you have this?
This right here is a rasp. It takes metal out really fast.
It's probably too late, but sorry, headphone users.
Anyway. Delayed! Yeah, it's a rasp. Check it out. It's really got like sharp teeth, and it hogs metal out real good because we got to make these a little bit bigger to fit the ball joint. Same thing we did with the Rhino. Safety first. Idea of where the ball joint's gonna be, we're about 10 degrees off on our camber, so I'm gonna put a ball joint in the lower one, see where we're at, where that's at, but we might have to do a little modification to the upper A-arm to correct the camber, so yeah.
So that's coming up right here, right? Like that's literally
where once this ball joint's in, then we can see where we're at, and we'll catch some footage of that, what it looks like, and how we're gonna fix it.
All right, well, we'll just snap into what the situation of that's gonna be now.
So we got some good, we got some bad, and we got some wild. I guess we'll just jump into the Western stuff.
Here's the factory control arm.
It's cute little thing.
We put that back up there just for measure. And then here's the other side. Yeah, that's a pretty drastic difference.
Yeah.
So what else needs to be done? Let's explain what's going on while I've got this pan right here.
So, like we mentioned before, the angle of the plate with the ball joint on.
We talked about that off camera.
Oh, we did?
Yeah, you didn't tell them. Oh, you didn't tell these guys this.
Hey, people. we got a little off on our measurements somehow. Our redneck plumb bob led us astray.
Maybe it was my measuring skills, not gonna lie.
Yeah, it could have been that too. Any number of things. But the somehow our measurements are off and we're 10 degrees off on our camber and we don't have enough adjustment in our heim joints to correct that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut this plate off, trim it back, it don't need much. Just trim it back here a little bit, move this plate up and get that camber a lot closer. But for the most part, everything else is looking pretty good.
So we have an axle right over there. Do you want to throw that in there and see what that kind of looks like?
We look at the axle.
And these came off a factory razor, I think, right?
Articat.
Mama!
Hey!
Hey, we're filming here!
We're filming here!
Hey!
Because it's what we do.
It's what we do.
It's on this side, silly goose.
Oh, here? Okay. So.
Just a representation.
Reference. Of what the axle angle is gonna look like.
So
something like that.
factory Arctic Cat, and it's actually measurement to measurement is really close.
It's
actually
close, where they need to be. It's really close to where.
But that's about the degree of what that axle will essentially look like. And what did we say it was a minute ago? It was like 30 and some change.
34 degrees.
34 degrees. So, yeah. Thank you, Aaron.
Yep.
Van away. All right, but yeah, so we finally got the brackets hanging. This side is hanging too. We just have it laid over so we can show y'all what that factory arm looked like in comparison to this one. So
yeah, the front is I'm not gonna say done, but it is mocked up. Obviously, we got to change some stuff.
The tie rod.
Yeah, we also have to do the tie rods, like Aaron is saying. What else on the front, though, other than the tie rods?
Tie rods, we've got to get axles, adjust the angles, and then, fully weld everything up. You know, little adjustments, little tweaks here and there, but...
So not a whole lot, though. I mean, this was the big, bite of the front.
Yeah.
So I think probably when we pick back up, we are on the rear?
Yeah. Hopefully.
I think so, too. Here. Telling y'all, it's going to be wild. Y'all got to stick around. It's going to get Western as... Because I don't think anyone's done it the way we're gonna do this on the four wheeler.
No.
On a four wheeler. I don't know. But we'll see. So I guess, guys, if y'all made it this far, we appreciate you guys, every single one of you. Big shout out to the 750 sub mark. Hats off to you guys. Much love. Check out our website. We got some sticker stuff on there. Some koozies. Shout out Logan Knoll for calling us out in his last video. Logan Knoll is definitely not mechanic, so there you are, bud. There's a shout out to our website because we're really worried about it. But anyway, yeah, we got a website. Check it out. There's probably a link over there if Alan wants to put it there. Like this video if you enjoyed it. Comment down below if you're ready to see some more brute stuff and ready for this thing to be done in, April of 2022. And what else? Oh, hit the sub. So you can help us grow. We appreciate that. If you're into that. And notification bell. Come right there. Guys, again, thank you so much for watching. We appreciate it, and we'll see you on the next one.